Hi friends, in the previous tutorial I introduced a trapezoidal rule to find area under a curve, or to find a numerical integration. We solve the problem and we get 23.35 the result. And for whom interest to see the tutorial, you can find the link for the tutorial in the description. Okay, let us start to find the error for trapezoidal rule. The error of the trapezoidal formula can be estimated in two ways. The first one, call it preliminary error estimation, which can be used to determine in advance how many subintervals the original interval should be divided into in order to make the approximation smaller than a predetermined error. So we have an error. According to that error, we have to divide the original interval into subintervals. That is the formula for preliminary error estimation. The second one, call it ex post error. This one, after a calculation, after using trapezoidal rule, we can find the error in the result. Okay. I show you using the both formula. Okay, let's start from the preliminary error. First, let us use the preliminary error formula for finding the number of some intervals. We have the interval, original interval minus 3 and 4, and we have to use a trapezoidal rule with our error equal to 0.01 or less. So we have this formula. Exact value minus numerical value is an error. That is the error. So error should be less than or equal to b minus a cube over 12 n square multiply m2, where m2 is the maximum value of the second derivative of the function within the interval. Okay. Let us first find m2. That is the function of x which we have equal to 2 to power x. When we derive it, the first derivation equal to 2 to power x multiply m2, and the second derivative equal to 2 to power x multiply m2 square. Let us plot the second derivative. We see that the maximum value at the upper end point of the interval. We get the maximum value for the second derivative at 4. Just replace x with 4. So second derivative equal to 2 to power 4 multiply ln 2 squared, we get 76872. That is the value for m2. Okay. Using the formula for preliminary error, we get the number of subintervals. Okay, that is the formula. Just replace by the value. B equal to 4 minus a. A equal to minus 3. So 4 minus minus 3 cubed over 12 n to power 2. Multiply m2, which m2 equal to 7.6872, should be smaller or equal to the error. Error is 0.01. Simplify more. It equal 21,972.58, smaller than or equal to n to power 2. Then square root both sides, we get n equal to or greater than 148.2350. Thus, an error of less than 0.01 requires at least 149 subintervals. Before we start using trapezoidal rule, we know that we have to divide original interval into 149 subintervals to get a result with less than 0.01 error. That was the preliminary error. And for the case of ex post error, we have to find t sub n and t sub n over 2. We already have the result for t sub n, and we have to use trapezoidal rule for find t sub n over 2. For finding t sub n over 2, we just consider every second division point. As we see in this case, n change from 10 to 5 and h from 0.7 change to 1.4. Why? we see we have five subintervals. This division point, we have six division point and five subintervals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. We see that from x from minus 3 goes to 1, minus 1.6. The distance between these two division points is 1.4. And also the distance between these two, the other two division points, minus 0.6, minus 1.6 to minus 0.2 is 1.4, and so on. Okay, let us use trapezoidal rule to find T sub 5. Just put the value of h 1.4 over 2 multiply the first y value plus 2 multiply summation of the intermediate y values plus the last y. More simplification, it equal 1.4 over 2 multiply 0.125 plus 2 multiply the summation, which is 9.5608 plus 16, and the result is 24.6726. The error will be t sub 10 minus t5 equal to the absolute value of 23.35 minus 24.6726 equal to 1.2926. That is the error. You have to be sure for this error estimation that the number of original subintervals must be even. That's all. I hope it can be helpful. Have a nice time.